tell her my faithful story. And that a stranger for a friend, the old man saying he had
Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon, everybody.
And you're all very welcome as we gather here in the Church of St. Vita here in Ashford to offer up the holy sacrifice of the Mass for our dear parishioner, Patty, or Patty as he was affectionately known, Patty Sheahan. And I'd just like to begin by extending our deepest sympathies to his sister, Joan, and to his nieces and grandnieces, relatives, friends, and neighbours. Patty, I suppose, hails from Tuonafulla originally, and he crossed the border into Killeedy, and he was very well accepted here in Killeedy, even though at times when maybe the relationship between Killeedy and Tour mightn't always be the best, especially on the Holland field. But anyway, Patty crossed the border, and he certainly made many tremendous friends here in Killeedy. And that was because of the kind of person he was. He was an easygoing, even-tempered, nice individual, quiet and unassuming. And we gather now this evening, or this afternoon, to bid him farewell, to send him home to God, to where he'll be with Kate and his beloved wife and all his dear friends. And may he enjoy the peace and the happiness of life eternal. And we begin our Mass now. Before we begin our Mass, we bring to the altar some symbols of Patty's life. Ailey now will introduce those to us.
The Observer of Pat Sheehan. The Observer was Paddy's favourite paper, and it was delivered every Wednesday morning by Pat. The Key of the Car, Oliver Key. Paddy was always made for the road, and no road was ever too long to meet with friends. The mobile phone, Tom Duell. Paddy was never short of a conversation, and the phone was never far from his sight. Rosary beads, Noel Collette. Peggy had great faith, and the beads were always hanging over his bed, and they brought him great comfort.
Thanks, Amy. So we begin now by our Mass by calling to mind our own faults and failures. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. We say it together around the continuity.
I confess all my faults,
my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary and the Virgin, all the angels and the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. God of mercy, look kindly on your servant Patty, who has set down the burden of his years. As he served you faithfully throughout his life, may you give him the fullness of your peace and joy. We give thanks for the long life of Patty, now caught up in your eternal love. We make our prayer in the name of Jesus, who is our risen Lord, now and forever. Amen. Be seated now for the reading. And the first reading will be read for us by his niece Maria Rose. And the second reading by Elaine Kennedy.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Pentecost Day came around, the apostles had all met in one room, when suddenly they heard what sounded like a powerful wind from heaven. The noise which filled the entire house in which they were sitting, and something appeared to them that seemed like tongues of fire. These separated and came to rest on the head of each of them. They were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak foreign languages, but the Spirit gave them the gift of speech, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The two are so opposed that you are not always carried out your good intentions. If you are led by the Spirit, no law can touch you. When self-indulgence is at work, the results are obvious. Fornication, gross indecency and sexual irresponsibility. Idolatry and sorcery, feuds and wrangling, jealousy, bad temper and quarrels, disagreements, factions, envy, drunkenness, orgies and similar things. I warn you now, as I warned you before, those who behave like this will not inherit the kingdom of God. What the Spirit brings is very different. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, trustfulness, gentleness, and self-control. There can be no law against things like that, of course. You cannot belong to Christ Jesus unless you crucify all self-indulgent passions and desires. Since the Spirit is our life, let us be directed by the Spirit, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and kindle in them the fire of your love. Day of the week, the doors were closed in the room where the disciples were for fear of the Jews. And Jesus came and stood among them, and he said to them, "Peace be with you," and showed them his hands and his side. The disciples were filled with joy when they saw the Lord, and he said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father sent me, so am I sending you." After saying this, he breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. For those whose sins you forgive, they are forgiven. For those whose sins you retain, they are retained." The Gospel of the Lord. Well, good afternoon once again, everybody, and especially I would just like to welcome all those who have joined us online. As you see, Marie over here is conveying the message of this ceremony out to people as far away as Australia, at his nieces and connections there. So you're all very, very welcome. And, of course, we gather here on the Feast of Pentecost. And I know that Maria, Patty's niece, will speak to you afterwards about Patty's life and the connection with his family and what Patty meant to everyone within his family. So I maybe just focus on our readings on this Pentecost Sunday, and maybe then link it up with Patty as well. And I'd just like to begin by, I suppose, drawing your attention that if you look around our churches, you will see many images of statues, paintings, and stained glass windows. And these are mainly images of Jesus, Our Lady, and the saints. You will not find too many images of the Holy Spirit. I suppose one image we have of the Holy Spirit is that of the dove. And I looked out my window this morning, I was feeding the birds in the backyard. And there on the feeding rest was a little dove, which I hadn't seen for a long, long time. What a coincidence that the symbol of the Holy Spirit would appear just the morning of Pentecost. In the Gospel, when Jesus was baptized, it says that the Holy Spirit descended on him in the form of a dove. And in our first reading today, it mentions two other images of the Holy Spirit, namely fire and wind. It says when the Holy Spirit descended on the apostles, it sounded like a powerful wind that shook the whole place, and it came to land on them in the form of tongues of fire. So on that first Pentecost, it says they heard what sounded like a powerful wind. And that was as close, I suppose, as one could get to describing the Holy Spirit. It was like a dove, like wind, like fire. Nothing concrete, because, as you know, the Holy Spirit is not visible. The Holy Spirit cannot be seen. Yet the Holy Spirit, despite that, is real. Just like there is a whole lot in our universe which cannot be seen by the naked eye. And yet, it is real. What we cannot see, very often we need a microscope, maybe a telescope, to identify it. But what we can see with our eyes is only a fraction of what is around us. Take, for example, a simple thing like, which we are all well aware of at the moment, and for the past over a year, is the virus. The virus cannot be seen, but we see its effect all around us and the effect it has had on our whole world. Wind is the same. Wind cannot be seen, but we can see the impact that wind has on objects and on people. And the same can be said of the Holy Spirit. We cannot see it because it belongs to the spiritual world, which no scientific instrument can detect. But we see the impact the Holy Spirit has on people's lives. St. Paul points this out. He says, wherever we find love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, gentleness, trustfulness, and self-control, the Holy Spirit is at work. The Spirit becomes visible in and through these qualities. And the one person who had all these qualities in abundance was Jesus, because he shared in the Father's love. And that is what the Holy Spirit is. It's the shared love between Father and Son. And it was this shared love that was poured out on Pentecost Sunday on Jesus' disciples, and then on all believers, including ourselves. St. Paul puts it very simply. He said, God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. And it was obvious from the way people spoke about Patty that the Holy Spirit played an active part in his long life. He was described as a gentleman, quiet, unassuming, a great neighbor, a perfectionist. He possessed those values that St. Paul spoke about in describing the active presence of the Holy Spirit in a person's life. Patty lived a good life, he had great qualities, and every year on his wife Kit's anniversary, he had Mass offered, and you were invited back to the house. He was a man of faith, and it was a lived faith. So we commend Patty to our Lord, and pray that he will be reunited with his wife Kit and all his departed loved ones. Send forth your Spirit, O Lord, and bring Patty to that place of lasting peace, truth, love, and beauty. And may he rest in peace. Amen. Amen. invite you all to stand for us who are doing prayers of faith and of faith. Raised Christ, his Son, from the dead, and so with confidence we ask him to save all his people, living and dead.
For Patty and for all the faithful departed, especially those whom Patty knew was close to, that God may receive them now into the light, happiness, and peace of his kingdom. Our tears.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Family and friends of Patty and all who are mourning his death, that God may look upon you in compassion and show you his love. May the memories of the love and care you extend for Patty bring you consolation and peace. God hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For those who nurse Patty in his illness, especially grateful to Eilish, that all of them will be rewarded for their gentleness and care. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For ourselves, that we may continue our earthly journey, steadfast in faith, joyful in hope, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And this being the month of May, and conscious that Patty had great devotion to Our Lady, we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brother Patty. Cleanse him of his sins and grant him the fullness of redemption. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Receive now the offering. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that as promised by your Son, the Holy Spirit may reveal to us more abundantly the hidden mystery of this sacrifice, and graciously lead us into all truth, through Christ our Lord. And the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For bringing your paschal mystery to completion, you bestowed the Holy Spirit today on those you made your adopted children. by uniting them to your only begotten Son. It's the same Spirit as the Church came to birth, open to all peoples the knowledge of God, and brought together the many languages of the earth in profession of the one faith. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which would be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." And the mystery of faith. Save us, Saviour of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your Church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one Spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Ita and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing God. May this sacrifice of all reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and the salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim Church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Brendan our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout this world. Remember your servant Patty, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes, for seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. And through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
And so together we pray with confidence to God our Father, the words Jesus our Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And do not let us fall into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. We pray now together for our peace, peace in our own homes, in our own lives, in our world. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. And the peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word that my soul should be. Filled with the Holy Spirit and spoke of the marvels of God. Hallelujah. Any of you Eucharistic minister here, we could do it in their help if you're away. Any?
Thank you.
most holy, your sacrament of the Lamb, our praise, love, thanksgiving. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful, and enkindle in them the fire of your divine love. Send forth your Spirit, and new light and be created, and thou shalt renew the face of the earth. Let us. O God, who bestow heavenly gifts upon your church, safeguard, we pray, the grace you have given, that the gift of the Holy Spirit poured out upon her may retain all its force, and that this spiritual food may gain her abundance of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord. And the Lord be with you, and let us bless the Lord. So before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother Patty. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Sprinkling of the coffin reminding us of Patty's baptism all those years ago when he became a member of the Christian family. And then we have the incensation of the coffin reminding us that our bodies are temples of God's Holy Spirit and we should always treat them with respect. Response is, receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Saints of God, come to his aid, come to meet him, angels of the Lord.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to Abraham's side.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and the perpetual light shine upon him. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Patty, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Patty in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, Patty, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ, and we are with you and with our brother forever. Amen. As you are besieged, as Marie would like to say.
How we remember Patty, from Mary, Eileen, and Joanne. We may be many miles away from home, but family are always in the forefront of our minds, and especially in times like this. We spend some time together on Friday as a family and reminisced about the good old days, and we thought it was only fitting to share them with you all. Paddy loved life, and he was certainly loved by all who knew him. He had the most incredible neighbours and close friends. The house was never short of company, and everyone was always made welcome. We remembered, as kids, the joy at Nash's truck pulling up outside our house with weekly delivery of ready beneath. Paddy never seemed to be in a rush, and always had time for a chat. He knew everyone, and everyone knew him. He was full of diplomat and roguish smile that was always on his face. He could talk about anything, and always had a story to share. Paddy was a very proud man, and we remember him as always being happy and healthy. We all thought he would be around forever, as he was always just Paddy, and happy with his lot. We recall the first time he met his grandniece Paulina from Australia. His first words were, "She is such a lovely little lady." For all his charm and wit, there was another side to the man we loved even more. If you met him in Strand or at the Devon Inn, you certainly wouldn't want to be in a hurry, as he had a great way of persuading you to stay for just one more. Our man can testify to this. It is well known that Paddy is the only man that had our man at the Devon Inn on a high stool at 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Not that we are saying he was a bad influence, just that time seemed to fly by in his company. Paddy's first love was his wife, Kate, and they had an incredible marriage for almost 42 years. We were looking back at photos, old and new, and the one thing that stands out is how well he always looked. Mam shared their wedding photo with us, and they looked like film stars on the day. He took great pride in his appearance, and we were always proud to be in his company. I loved when he called to our house for a visit. We can all take comfort in knowing a true gentleman who has left this world to make his mark in heaven. On behalf of our man and ourselves, we would like to thank everyone for all your heartfelt condolences, and especially Maria Roach, who has been a huge support and comfort to our mother in our absence. We are forever grateful. And finally, as a fitting tribute to Paddy, can you all raise a glass of his favourite tipple, a drop of whiskey, and a toast, a very special man.
For those lovely words. And so now, in peace, let us take our Paddy to his place.